This is an actual patient you're going to be seeing today who had two failed lingual frenectum releases. And this photo was taken the day after Dr. Zaghi's lingual frenectum release. You're also going to see an upper lip frenectomy where the patient already had a failed procedure. You can see the scar tissue here at 10 days is forming and causing it to reattach to the lip. This is the same patient at 5 weeks. You can see there's been a lot of reattachment. This is the same patient after Dr. Zaghi redid the procedure. This is also day 10, and you can see in contrast, there is no scar tissue.
Good. So you see how the floor of mouth is elevating here? This is a compensation right here. This shouldn't be so much strain right here. So the target of surgery would be deep in here.
Part of the reason why the lingual frenectomy failed before was because of these large blue blood veins that you can see on either side of the tongue. Dr. Zaghi has developed specialized procedures that allows him to go deeper into the tongue and further to the side without damaging those blood vessels so that he can get a deeper, wider release. One of the ways he does this is by using a Q-tip to safely release the connective tissue from around the blood vein and be able to clean the area of blood and connective tissue so that he can clearly see which tie downs need to be cut. And he cuts those with a scalpel so that he can have detailed, precise control over exactly what he's cutting so that he can go deeper and wider. After consulting with the patient to make sure that he's gotten a full release, he places selective sutures to help prevent the tongue from scarring down. The other procedure you will see is an upper lip frenectum release. As you can see here, it's fully healed and the lip has not reconnected to the frenectum. One of the ways Dr. Zaghi does this is by using surgical scissors to very cleanly and completely remove the frenectum so that it does not regrow or heal tighter. Then he sutures it completely closed, and without having to open up any further, he's able to release even more connective tissue with a Q-tip.
That's what you need. The scar, the laser is so bad.
Yeah, it is. So it's just a lot of scar tissue. Yes.
These procedures can help with jaw pain, function, sleep, and allergies. Now let's show you the process from start to finish. Dr. Zaghi is now going to start the lingual frenectomy.
Take a deep breath in.
He's developed techniques to try to make
slowly let it out.
The experience.
Deep breath in.
As pain-free as possible for the patient.
Good. Deep breath in. Slowly, slowly let it out.
Now Dr. Zaghi is starting to very carefully and precisely cut for the lingual frenectomy, making sure he cuts as little as possible so there will be as little scar tissue as possible while getting the maximum release of tie-down material.
You doing okay?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to use the retracting stitch to help hold the tongue. This isn't what we normally do. This is what we have to do in this case.
Dr. Zaghi is making small, precise cuts to make sure that he is only cutting as much as he needs to while still cutting everything he needs to.
Scar tissue we're going through here.
Mm-hmm.
Dr. Zaghi has now run into some scar tissue from a previous frenectomy, so he's going to have to familiarize himself with it, examine it, make sure exactly where it is, and then carefully excise all of the scar tissue. Right now he's cleaning the area so he can clearly see what he's doing.
So it's going.
Mm-hmm.
Hold this, this here, same thing. Hold this one here.
Not only does the Q-tip clean the area so he can see what he's doing, but it is releasing a lot of the fascia so that he can make fewer cuts and less trauma to the tongue.
So pushing the blood vessel down so we can get into it. See the blood vessel goes
down?
Yes,
I do. I see the right there.
If that small release, see that fascia band there? That small release is going to give her a lot of tension relief.
After completely releasing both sides and consulting with the patient to make sure there has been a full release, Dr. Zaghi places strategic sutures to help the tongue heal together instead of from tip to base, so that we're trying to minimize shrinkage from tip to base. Now Dr. Zaghi is going to release the upper lip. Now we're going to show you the procedure.
Deep breath in, slowly let it out.
Dr. Zaghi is going to remove the phrenectrum.
Should we do a little more?
Are you numbing?
Do you feel it?
No, I don't feel it.
Okay.
By removing the phrenectrum material completely, there's less of a chance that it will grow back. Shortly after this procedure, this patient had Botox injections under the nose. This caused the tissue to relax, and she has reported that her severe allergy symptoms have not returned since the procedure was done.
Let's see.
You okay here?
Uh-huh.
That's what you need. This scar, the laser is so bad.
Yeah, it is. So it's just a lot of scar tissue.
It's better.
He's releasing the remaining tissue.
Look at how easy this is. And you just put a Q-tip.
Sorry.
No, I'm good. I'm good.
Hold the lip here, please. Hold the lip.
He will place small sutures all the way up the entire length of the incision. This was 10 days after this patient had their previous release done with a laser and without sutures. And then this is the result. These overly tight attachments were still there. This is the same patient, also on day 10 after Dr. Zaghi's procedure. As you can see here, it's fully healed and the lip has not reconnected to the phrenectrum.